is when I'm streaming. I don't like that my screen gets smaller. How it makes the little space for the little thing on the side. I don't like that. Yo, what does your screen look like when you're streaming on the P5? What you mean nothing changes? Excuse me.
Just a gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out. Roof open. Yes,
yes.
Yes,
your screen doesn't look like this.
Football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. The scene a few moments ago. Here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the.
Well, I just sent you on Snap. Your screen look like that.
As their guys are ready to do battle.
But that's the case. They racist.
And the Dallas Cowboys. The NFL season has hit high gear.
Your screen don't look like that. Yours just says streaming. Nigga said on air. It just has a little logo pop up that says on air. You just start streaming. Wow. It just pops up on the screen. Wow. No. I copy Dante's live stream. Show me the live videos. I still can't find it. Oh, it's a capital D, capital L. It's a capital D, capital L. You said no spaces? Dante, you said no spaces?
Just a gorgeous fall afternoon
nothing.
In the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out. Roof open.
Yes.
A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions
to
an NFL game
if they stream sniping. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name fuck it, viewers are good, man. Ready as their guys get set to match up between the Miami Dolphins and the Dallas Cowboys. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. Just think it's more for like shooting games, like, oh, he's over here, so I'm going to go score where he is without him again. A lot of people do it. I think it's sick. Yeah, so you know he's headed regardless. Yeah.
And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he'll power his way up near the 25. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
At the 24-yard line.
Six yards on that last play. Here's second and four.
Not in there yet.
And he's just going to get rid of this thing. To no one here, he throws it away. And now it's third.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tuck rule that they can fall back on anymore.
And they'll look to avoid an early three and out here on third and four. They'll look to throw here. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Well, that's one way to convert on third down, picking up 26 yards. Throw complete into the flat out left. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Well, as a lineman, they are trained. You've got to stay close to home. If you're more than a yard downfield, they're going to toss that flag, and they did there.
I think so.
After the penalty, it's Elliott. They get 1 yard back there to make it second and 14. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself.
You went crazy for the string.
Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
I don't know. I don't think so.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 35. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a second and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a second and 3. They'll look to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 30. He's at the 40, the 20, and he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. Bring it, baby, bring it.
Well, it certainly looked to me like he tapped into the quarterback's thought process there, and what I'm hearing more and more when I go around the league, defenders sitting in on quarterback meetings trying to learn more about how they think so they can be in the right position to be in the right spot, as he was there to pick that one off. and take it all the way back for a touchdown.
Jason Sanders now for the extra point. And that makes it 7-0 Dolphins.
Is good. Makes the score Dolphins 7, Cowboys nothing. Jason Sanders to kick off for Miami.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away.
All right, Kelly, let's clean it up.
This will make it into the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And following the pick six, and they had decent field position in throwing that pick six, we'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told him, they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Steps away to his left.
Isn't mad.
And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds. Because they're very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
Flushed out right. He's going to take off. And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield. And this is picked up by the Dolphins. And they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line.
Recovered.
You think about it, Charles. This is not a quarterback that's used to running the football a lot. And that time he was loose with it, had it knocked free.
He always has to think to himself that there's always going to be traffic around because of what you just said. Not that elusive. Not going to get into the open field very often. Remember, he's not Lamar Jackson, not Michael Vick back in the day. Always has to protect the football because there's always going to be people around.
Following the fumble recovery, here's Tua, and that's complete. Albert Okwuegbunam. A gain of 6 there on first.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and 4. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. That'll be complete to Breida. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. But at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best. And keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
Looks for Parker, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 24, and they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. They're trying to resurrect his confidence. Last week was a disaster. 5 interceptions in that loss, and another pick there.
I played with a quarterback like this before, and he had a tough game, and the head coach said, I'll take him. I'll fix him. The very next game.
And got his man complete. Touchdown, Cowboys. CeeDee Lamb with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7.
John Brown set to kick off.
So I'll leave it at 7 now as they kick it away.
What's up? What's up, man? How y'all doing? Yeah, I'm losing all minds.
Out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
Bro, this is amazing. Who would have thought, man? We on TV.
Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. They had the interception last drive, led to the tying touchdown. So 7-7 the score as they begin first and 10. Here's the first carry from Matt Breida. And it worked his way across the 30 to the 32. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
Let me pin his comment. Is that bad?
Say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
On second down, a run with Breida. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go and run the football in that situation.
Oh, I see it.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
We here.
From the gun, it's Tua. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end.
Now what?
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Dolphins first down. Tagovailoa working out of the gun.
Oh my God, man.
And it's complete.
Wow.
And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down.
He called me Big Fur.
Looking to pass, Tua. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
Intended for his running back.
Why's he dropping that?
It leads to second and 10.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. Again, they will throw it with Tagovailoa. He'll get this into the hands of Breida. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
Third down.
Tua setting up shop to throw again. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 17-yard line. These two teams all tied after one.
Why does Rock Lee look so different since the last time I opened it? Now, what is this background? Why does the back of the map, why does it look like that? Like the outside of the ring. I ain't never seen this before.
3 tight ends in the ball game here on 1st and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw, and this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's 2nd down.
Once you get into the red zone, space is at a premium for receivers to try and operate and shake themselves free. That one's incomplete.
An incomplete pass on 1st down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. And again, it's Tagovailoa. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
They'll try to pick this up on the ground with Breida.
And
he gets
right
the
now.
First down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the six. They give him 2 yards there as they're set up now with a first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And the Dolphins are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
When you look at the geography we're staring at, this part of the field, don't you always think of big backs carrying the football, bruisers trying to pound it in? Instead, look at a little more of a scat back type, and he's trying to make it happen.
Yeah, they went with the elusive, slippery guy. Couldn't get in there, though. Try to run with Breida, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down. Tua gonna hand this one to Breida. He's not gonna get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. Nothing doing there as the 13th play of the drive proves to be unlucky. The kick by Sanders is good. And the Dolphins will jump out to a 3-0 lead. So they get the field goal, but that was a 14-play drive to get 3.
Sounds like you're going negative on that.
I was.
Sounds like you're thinking the 3 is just not that good.
And people say that we're negative sometimes. So.
Well, here's the deal. Getting the 3 is good. Obviously, you would think on a 14-play drive you're going to get 6 out of it. But that type of a drive can pay dividends later on because you might wear the...
There he goes, right side. Touchdown, Cowboys! He goes 91 yards on the kick return, and the Cowboys have retaken the lead.
Well, it's the stream, man. Y'all truly be
so
fans.
Fun to watch, and you need all 11 guys in sync for that to be successful, don't you?
Without a doubt. That's teamwork, to be able to put it all together. But that play is really probably the most exciting 10 seconds in football.
We lost our minds.
So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it, forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. Tua wants to throw it on second down. This taken in by Jakeem Grant. And he'll be out right at the 35. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
Brings up third and inches.
Dolphins on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. They're looking at third and a few inches. Out of the shotgun, Breida. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Dolphin first down. That right there, a good sign for a team that's had trouble converting third down so far this year. They're the bottom five in the NFL, but they come through there.
Yeah, and I bet if we put our guy Marvin on the case and say, Marvin,
don't you score?
Tell us where they rank on third and one, right? I bet they're in the top five in the league. On third and five, third and six, third and seven or more, because that's how you end up not converting. Just too much yardage to pick up on third down.
And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Back at his 48-yard line.
Second down, Tua. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 39. And a return across midfield into the 46-yard line. He has just been a load for opposing offenses to account for. Now 8 interceptions on the year.
I love that number because I always think of center field. You know, when I hear 8, because that's the position you write in the scorecard in baseball. And what do good center fielders do? Catch all the alleys, right? They range deep and make a whole lot of great catches.
This is caught inside the 15. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. That goes for a gain of 31. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. And he's going to keep it here. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
So not quite a first and goal just yet.
I got 80 more.
Now second and inches. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. Chalk that up as a 4-yard loss. And now it's third down.
The tackle made back at the 9-yard line.
Depends how long you're there, yeah. You got to remember, bro, your time is 3 hours behind.
The big play to start the drive, not much sense.
Got to remember, your time zone is 3 hours behind. So when you get inside and think it's normal, we got an eye shut.
A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Flush to his right. He may truck now. Loose football. The ball comes out. And this is picked up by the Dolphins. And a big turnover there as his guys will give the football back. Good job starting on that scramble. Had his eyes on that first down marker, CD, but lost the most important thing, the football.
Yeah, wasn't quite there. Focused solely on getting to the first down marker. Forgot to cover up and take care of the ball.
I just see a bucket. Is that what I just seen?
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go,
pretend that I just see a bucket out of here.
Just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. To the air on second down, Tagovailoa. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. They got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. If you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. Tua gonna throw. Gonna throw right side here, complete. Now the Dolphins gonna burn the first of their timeouts. As they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down.
First down, Dolphins.
Wow.
Tua to throw again. Oh, and Tua going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked off near the 34. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Escaping the pressure right. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And it's caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Cowboy touchdown. A 14-yard touchdown. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. Now they'll line up to kick the extra point. It's good, and it's 21-10.
Makes the score Cowboys 21, Dolphins 10. John Brown set to kick off.
Brown now to kick it away after the touchdown. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever.
And the Cowboys pressure gets there this time for the sack. DeMarcus Lawrence, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
It's second down.
Tagovailoa to throw on second down here. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds.
Oh, I can't get my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big. But in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
Third and long, it's Tagovailoa. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Kitabay Awuzie with a pick.
You're trailing, you're trying to get points late in half. I absolutely understand that. But remember, it's all about the ball. And without the ball, you can't get those points. They just turned it over.
Now you got to be careful because that deficit can get a little bigger on the other side with that good field position they just took over with. First play of the drive there is incomplete.
That was nice work there defensively to force incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
Looking left side, and it's complete. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. They'll look to throw here on first down. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete.
3 more yards.
23 yards of the play.
First down. First down.
Don't say that to me.
cap off a big first half here as they come up on first and goal. They'll try to run it in with Elliott. And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the three. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look like to reverse that trend on second and goal.
Because I'm listening on my phone.
Second and three. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. CeeDee Lamb is intended target, but now it's third and goal.
Brings up third and
goal.
The line of scrimmage is the three as they look to cash in on third and goal. There's a quick throw out left. It's complete. A great job to hold him to just a yard there. Now it's fourth and goal.
A gain of a yard. It's now fourth and goal.
Wow. Drive that.
Time for one final play here in the half, so they will go for it on fourth down. On fourth and goal, here's the option. Going quickly out to the right side. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. CeeDee Lamb in the final seconds of the first half. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. And the lead is up to 18 now.
John Brown set to kick off.
So still time for the kickoff here. 1 second to go in the half as this one is away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Tua, a final shot before half. He's going to look deep down the field. And it's knocked away and incomplete. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
John Brown set to kick off.
The Dolphins down on the scoreboard, but they'll have it first as we get going in this third quarter. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. Tua now on first down. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Now Tua. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Grant. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 33. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. The first half did not go their way, and that's not going to help matters at all. An interception here on the opening drive of the third quarter.
Obviously not what they were striving to accomplish. But you know who's really upset on their team? The defense. Already trailing, they're going to be counted on to try and hold that score at least where it is.
They'll try and get the running game going with Elliott. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
The 33-yard line.
A quick throw complete into the flat-out left. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
To number 80. That's a gain of six. Brings up third and three.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Open man Lamb, it's complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Something we're seeing more of with a rise in the run-pass option. A legal man downfield, and that's going to back him up. The play-action fake. They'll look to throw. Flushed out right. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play.
42-yard line.
Here's a quick throw out left. That's caught. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two.
That's nice, man.
They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Brings up third down and two.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as this defense unable to hold. It's a 7-yard gain there on third and two. They'll look to throw now on first down. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys. That's out to the left, flat and complete. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here, second and 11. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown.
John Brown.
A 16-yard touchdown. And the Cowboys will extend their lead. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him, let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC.
Run after catch. And he loves that. And he's going to carry that in at contract time.
Made at the 25-yard line. The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in good spot, great place to run some of your best
person you're playing with.
Instead, they turn the ball over.
They turned the ball over last time. See if they can avoid doing it here. Dallas, Texas is the spot. Third quarter inside AT&T Stadium. Glad you're with us. Second and 10. And he will go down. A Cowboys sack. DeMarcus Lawrence. Make that now 8 sacks for him on the season.
6 yards.
Out of the gun on third down. Here's Tua. And he's got him. Got his man on the end route. Complete. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. It'll be a pickup of 14, but they're still a little bit short as it brings up fourth. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Eluding the pressure right. He'll run it. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard.
It's a gain of 9. Brings up 2nd and a yard.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Looking for the end zone. And this is caught for a Cowboy touchdown. CeeDee Lamb, his 3rd touchdown of the game, number 9 on the season. As his guys continue to put this one out of reach. And he knocks it through.
Makes the score Cowboys 42, Dolphins 10.
Brown now to kick it away after the touchdown.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Dolphins take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
That's the reason we go for circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And last time out, went for it on 4th down, turned it over, gave them great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on 4th down,
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Now this one complete on the slant route, and he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That one good for 13 and a Dolphin first down.
But maybe this offense has learned something from watching their counterparts work. I'm wondering if their coaching staff said, let's do what they've been doing the entire game, because that's worked well. This offense, they have not looked particularly good on.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Snags it for the pick. So it'll be a change of possession on the turnover when we get back. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. On play action, they'll throw. He'll fire deep downfield for... He's got a man, complete. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. A heck of a way to start the 4th quarter, just south of 40 yards of the pickup. Now on 1st down, he'll drop to throw him. And he will find his man on the end route, complete.
The pass.
So not quite a 1st down just yet as they come up on 2nd and less than a yard.
At the Dolphins' 34-yard line.
He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be 3rd down. The Cowboys on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. They're looking at 3rd in the nose of the football. With 1 complete. And he will have a Cowboys 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Instead of a 3rd and 1 run, they go pass and they get 12 yards out of it. play fake here on first down. And his throw's going to be incomplete. CeeDee Lamb is intended target.
CeeDee Lamb.
And that'll bring up second down.
Xavien Howard on the coverage.
Dumped off to his running back, and he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. The Cowboys on third down. They've converted four times out of six. Not bad. This is third and 11. And he took the contact as he was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete.
For number 10.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
And his kick is indeed good. Now they're sitting pretty now as the lead grows even further. So it's three more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
At the 25-yard line. The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. It's now appearing that this losing streak is going to continue. You know, the coaching staff was confident that this was going to be the game to stem the tide, but that just has not been the case. And now a throw here secured by his running back out of the backfield. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
And the Dolphin first down.
Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. And now here is another interception. He's picked off at his own 47. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. The utter domination here just continues. This defense, I don't know what more we can say all around about their performance.
Well, it certainly feels in this game like maybe they're facing a Canadian defense. 12 guys on the field. It feels like there's an extra on every snap because they have really struggled to make headway through the air.
And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
It leads to second and 10.
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. It's a gain of 35. Boy, another big play late here for an offense, Charles, that certainly has had its fair share of big plays.
Coverage has been a problem all game long, and I would say that going along with that has been confidence. Because even if they had the right coverage, they've still dented them, and now it's been a real issue for them during this game.
He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. Yeah, this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. Second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Xavien Howard. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
First and 10.
Tagovailoa and the Dolphins come up first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. After the turnover, it's Tua. And the Cowboys as pressure gets there this time for the sack. Neville Gallimore coming right up the gut. Gets in there for a loss of 9. The throw over the middle taken in. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. 27 yards there. A first down.
A gain of 27 on the play. First down, Dolphins.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. And the pressure gets there, and Tua's going to be taken down. Neville Gallimore picks up his second sack of the afternoon. Tua wants to throw it on second down. Wide open receiver complete. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete.
And
he's going to have another shoot. First down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 35.
He shoots fast.
And again, it's Tagovailoa. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Akello Witherspoon.
What else would you want it for?
And it's a good return here as he'll get all the way up close to the 35. CD, this defense, man. At this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
And normally with this type of a lead, if you're a starter on defense, you're saying, hey, let the other guys play. But with this going on, no one wants to come out of the game. They all want their shot at picking off a pass.
That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down.
At the 32-yard line.
They're really the same gun. One just shoots energy, one shoots light rounds.
Looks like he'll throw here. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And it's incomplete. They're still throwing
L-Star
to the very end.
Stronger.
But now this game is over.
Not the L-Star, I meant the Volt. My bad.
It's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points. Continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Dallas, that's now 5 wins on the campaign as they get the job done here. And now they'll have the short week ahead as they'll host their annual Thanksgiving Day game on Thursday. Meanwhile, for Miami, add one more loss to the column. That drops them to a woeful 1-9 so far. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.